Hello friends, I am Satyendra and today in this video we will learn how to solve this question. This question was asked in gate to in a CSIR NET December 2012, and in this question you were given the eigenstate psi, and in this state psi they asked you to calculate the expectation, okay, of operator LZ in the state psi. Okay, so let's see how to solve this question. So the first thing is that the answer is the answer was H naught upon 8. Okay, and let's see how we can bring this answer. Okay, so friends, the first thing is that the expectation of LZ in the state psi is given by this equation. And if you are unaware of this equation, then just remember this equation. Okay, okay. Now in this equation I have substituted the value of psi from the question here. Okay, and also I have substituted the value of psi here also and here also, so this equation is clear to you. Okay, now in this equation I have operated LZ on this, LZ on this, LZ on this, and LZ on this, so it is clearly written here. And my next step here is that I have to solve this expectation or normalization. Okay, so first I have to operate this on this. Okay, so it is clearly written here. Okay, and then I will have to operate this over this, but that will give you zero because the basis sets are orthonormal. You can see that the basis sets are orthonormal, so if their subscripts are not equal then they will give you zero. So that's why if I operate this and on this, then that will give me zero. That's why I have not written them. Okay, okay, so again when this will be operated on this, that will be zero. This will be operated on this, that will give you zero. This will operate on this, then that will give you zero. So I now in the next term, when this will operate on this, that will give you zero, but when this will operate on this, that will not give you zero, but that will give you one. So I have written it, when you will operate this on this, then I will get this quantity, and I have written it very clearly. Okay friends, similarly you have to do this. Okay, so this equation is also clear to you. Okay, now friends, in order to solve this part, okay, you need to know this character eigenvalue equation. Okay, so just remember it. So when LZ operates on this wave function where the subscripts are L, M and N, then you get the eigenvalue M into H naught. Okay, and this m comes from the wave function m here. Okay, and then you again get your wave function. Okay, so we will use this property to solve this eigenvalue problem. Okay, and then now see let's what we have done. Okay, so now I have solved this part, and you can see that the m is zero in this. Okay, and H naught is came from here as it is written here. Okay, and again we get the eigenvalue as it is written here. Okay, so in this fashion we have solved this entire equation here, and you can clearly see that. Okay, and then we know that this normalization is equal to 1 because it was given that the basis sets are normalized. Okay, so it has came to 1, this is also equal to 1, this is also equal to 1, and this is also equal to 1. Okay, so this equation is now clear to you. Okay, now let's see. Okay, now we come to our this equation and let's see something. Okay, now here the eigenvalues are 0, and here also the eigenvalues was 0. Okay, so that's why here we get the two zeros here is 0 and here is 0. Okay, now the remaining things are written here. Okay, now let's put the value of psi from the question here, and I have substituted the values, and also we have to put the value of psi here, and I have put the values, and now we have to solve this equation. Okay, when you solve this part you will get this thing. Okay, now let's see how to solve. So when you will solve this thing, so first have to operate this on this, and then you have to operate this on this, and then you have to operate this on this, and then you have to operate this on this. So here also we will use the orthonormal property. Okay, so similarly in this fashion this is also solved, and it is clearly written here. Okay, now when you have to solve this, then you can see that the subscripts are unequal, so this will give you 0. And when you solve this, then you can see that subscripts are equal, so you will get 1. And again when you will solve this, you will get 0, you will get 0 for here. Again when you solve this, you will get 0. When you will solve this, you will get 0. For this also you will get 0, but for this you will get 1. So you can clearly see that here it is written. Okay, now you just have to now solve these questions, solve these equations. It is simple algebraic equations, and you just have to do few mathematical operations, and then you can clearly solve it. Okay, so go through these equations and you can come to your answer. Okay, this is your answer. So thanks for watching this video. If you really like this video, then please subscribe, share and like this video. Okay friends, thank you. Okay, bye.